If you're anything like me, you have Christmas ornaments that may be several years old, or perhaps more. Many of mine are in really good shape, but this year, as I was taking them out of the storage boxes, I realized some were showing their age. I also have one new blown glass ornament that's missing a section of glitter, and after thinking about it, I realized there was a way to salvage all of them. As I was playing, I also realized the salvage effort could be used on ones that weren't showing their age so much, but just kind of needed to be spruced up. My solution? A little gel medium and a nice selection of glitter. This Salvage the Ornaments effort began when we were putting our tree up this year. I was taking some of the ornaments out of the tissue paper and realized that they weren't looking real good. If you look here, you can see this dark spot. It's dark. You can see to the inside. This is from a group of ornaments I bought years ago from Pottery Barn. They came in this mercury finish or mercury glass type finish and green, and you can see that even the green are really starting to show their age. They're kind of blotchy and dark in spots. I didn't want to throw them away because I really like them, and I wanted to find a way to salvage them. And then I'm playing with glitter for something else, and then it dawns on me that this is glass. Well, gel medium will adhere to glass, and I've got glitter, so I can fix these. I can make these look better. And then I decided, well, how can I play with some other ones and maybe do something fun with them? This didn't necessarily need to be salvaged, but it was a little boring, and I needed to spice it up a little bit. So I'm going to show you how to do this, how to really simply just cover an ornament with gel medium and then glitter it. And then I'm going to show you, so this is a blown glass ornament that I bought. This is actually new this year. And when I picked it up, I completely, don't ask me how, but I completely missed the fact that this was absent the glitter and the color right here. But I'm going to fix that. We'll get that looking really nice and no one will be the wiser. So when you do this, it's a really simple matter. I'm going to, let's do this heart because I haven't done one of the hearts. So I'm going to use gel medium, and then I'm going to use Tim's. This is the, this one here is the glitter dust, the distressed glitter dust and vintage platinum. I just think that it screams Christmas. It's the perfect Christmas color, although someplace here, well actually let me show you this. So I did one of the green with a turquoise color, but don't do what I did, which is to not put enough gel medium on. So you'll want to pay attention where you're putting it on. Gel medium, as I said, will adhere to most surfaces. I'm using Dina Wakely's gel medium. I'm going to put a little bit off to the side here. I don't want to take the brush and put it in the jar, because if I do and I have happened to get glitter on there, it just means that I'm going to end up contaminating that jar of gel medium with glitter. So I'm going to brush a decent coat on here. I want to get up to this little trim piece at the top of the ornament, but I don't want to glop it on that piece itself. I want to keep the glitter confined to just the actual glass area. Now, gel medium has enough body to it that if you put on a clump, and a big clump like that, and I'm really exaggerating, and you glitter that, unless you flatten it, that clump is going to stick up. So you want to bear that in mind as you're applying the gel medium, and you'll play a little bit and figure it out. It's that sort of fine line between, oops, I didn't put enough on, and now I can see the ornament underneath, or the color underneath, and oh well, that was too much, and I've got this big old gloppy thing on there I need to finish. So that looks pretty good. I'm going to put my brush to once, actually I'm going to scoop this up and put it back in the jar, and you'll notice that this is kind of an old crappy brush. I have brushes that I have reserved for just things like gesso or gel medium, because eventually, no matter how careful you think you're being when you clean them up, they end up getting all glopped up. So here's the Distressed Glitter Dust and Vintage Platinum. These are actually the little spoons from Art Glitter that we have, and I figured out that these actually work pretty well for this, rather than trying to control dump that entire jar on something as small as one of these ornaments. Now, if I wanted to, I could certainly kind of stick the ornament in the jar. It's small enough, and the mouth on the jar is wide enough that I could do that, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to do it this way. And my little tray here is just a piece of palette paper, and I've kind of formed it into this tray. It allows me to, got these little pointy corners, I can use that to kind of funnel the stuff back into the jar. So now that this is glittered, all I need to do is, I've got them kind of lined up, I'll put a hanger on this, and I can hang them up to allow them to dry so I don't do anything that nudges that gel medium and exposes some of the ornament itself underneath. So that's it, that's how simple it is. Next I'm going to show you how we can use gel medium, but in a little bit more dimensional effect like this, to get these dots on an ornament that didn't actually need anything more than making a little bit more interesting. Something I should have said a moment ago and it slipped my mind is the difference between opaque versus transparent glitter. Now I think that the words pretty much tell you what the difference is, but here's the difference when you actually use them. First of all, The Distress Vintage Glitter Dust is an opaque product. You don't have to worry about that at all. But when we talk about the glitter in the Art Glitter line, you have transparent and you have opaque. So this one is transparent. Now, putting aside the fact that I missed, you can see in the areas where I didn't that I can still see the green through that. This purple one was also done on a green ornament, but you can't see the green underneath because I used an opaque glitter. I also used an opaque glitter here, so you'll want to think about that. If you want some of the color underneath to show through, then the way to get that effect, and I don't think this is bad, it's just different than this, the way to get that is to use a transparent glitter. For what I'm going to do next, which is to show you how to put these dots on, I'm going to use an opaque glitter. The gel medium is going to dry transparent, so ultimately, if you use a transparent glitter for this technique, you may find that you're going to see the color of the ornament through it. Maybe that matters, maybe it doesn't. It's just food for thought. So I have this blue one here, and because I need this to repair my fish, which I'm going to do in a couple of minutes, I'm going to work with this glitter on this little ornament. You can, this is not a new ornament, but you can certainly do this. If you have new ornaments that you want to spice up a little bit, this is a great way to do that. So again, I'm coming back to the gel medium, but this time, rather than use the business end of the brush, I'm going to use the back end because I want to create dots or little globs of gel medium. So I'm going to take this much out. You can see what I've got there. Now I've got the whole thing covered, and all I'm going to do is go straight up and down and put a dot on there. Now you can see when I hold this on an angle that that makes that Hershey Kiss effect. I'm going to show you how to fix that in a minute. Now more gel medium is going to result in a bigger dot, although not necessarily a rounder one if you don't pay attention to what you're doing. But straight up and down is what's going to give you a round dot. Now I'm not going to do this whole ornament. You don't need to see me do the whole thing. How dense you put these dots is entirely up to you. You can really go with them very close together, kind of like I'm doing here, or you can spread them apart. But once you're satisfied with them, and nothing says that you have to do the entire ornament at once, because obviously what happens is you're liable to get your hands into something that you don't mean to if you're covered in gel medium here, or ultimately if you're covered in glitter. And once, because this is dimensional, that's why you get that Hershey Kiss effect, this needs to sit and dry thoroughly, and it's going to take a little bit longer because it's thick. So you have to have some patience with this. I would do half of one side and then come back once it's dry and do the other half. So now I'm going to bring in my little tray, grab my spoon, and I'm going to show you that all I do for this is just go ahead and drop glitter. Now again, because it's dimensional, I want to be sure that I get glitter on the entire little Hershey Kiss shape there. And then once I do, now you can't brush this off now. I'm going to tack that to knock some of the excess glitter off. What I want to do is flatten the kisses out. And the way to do that, there's glitter on the back of the spoon. So all I'm going to do is very lightly touch that. Now if you want to leave, I want to make sure I still have glitter on there. I don't want to take the glitter off. If you want to leave them in that Hershey Kiss shape, you certainly can. But the point is that you don't have to if your preference is to have them be a little bit smoother. Now the contrast on here is not quite as strong, but you can see that the ultimate effect, and if I hold this up, if I twist this, you can see that mine are not kiss-like, they've been flattened. So let's slide this over here for 1 second. I'm going to let that dry and do its thing, and hopefully it won't roll the way that I don't want it to. So here's the last thing, and here's how to repair an ornament that might have a missing section of glitter like this, or in this case, it's missing paint with a little bit of glitter on top. I'm going to fix that by glittering this entire area. So now I'm going to come back with the gel medium, and what I really should do is take some and put some out here so I don't risk, because there's already glitter on here, I don't want to risk getting glitter in the gel medium. So I'm not going to talk for a second. Because I kind of want to do this right. This is going to go on the tree as soon as it dries. And you'll notice that I'm actually putting gel medium over the existing glitter. I want to not get that in the wrong spot. I want this to be the same all over the place. I want the whole piece to be a uniform color. And the way to do that is to use an opaque glitter and cover everything that you want that color. All right, I think that looks good. And I can always come back with something. If I've got glitter where I didn't mean to, I can always come back with a palette knife or something, and I can nudge the glitter back into that area if it's not, if I've gotten gel medium where I didn't mean to. So again, the key here is that I'm using an opaque glitter. I'm going to turn this over and flick it. And there you go. How awesome is that? So now that's all the right color. There's none of that silver showing through. And if I want to come back and do under here to make this match, I certainly can. So whether you're repairing an ornament that has a boo-boo, or you're spicing up an ornament like this, or you simply decide to glitter an entire ornament, this process with the gel medium is and the glitter is simple and fast and easy. And it's something that you can do right up until Christmas if you suddenly discover that you've got this ornament that needs a little bit of help.